program created by the Rio Grande Oil Company.
San Francisco Police calling all cars, jumping all cars, broadcast 107. Pick up one Clyde Stevens. Released yesterday from San Quentin. And failed to report to San Francisco parole officer today. This man is described as medium height, weight 140, dressing suit.
How about some of those Rio Grande free gifts for my kids for Christmas?
Okay, sir. Here's the latest copy of the Calling All Cars News. It'll give you full information.
Oh, what's this? I see Rio Grande is a new gasoline. Rio Grande G-Gas, huh?
That's right. Well, what's the idea? Well, sir, a lot of motorists who want the cheapest gasoline they can buy. A lot of bootleg brands selling at cut prices, but they might be poor quality gasoline. So, Rio Grande has created this brand new G-Gas to protect motorists from bootleg quality. You see, it says right here on the pump. G-Gas exceeds United States government specifications number VG101.
Hmm. What does that mean?
Well, our government has set a standard of quality for gasoline. Well, it isn't safe to use gasoline under that standard. Not until these cut-price bootleg gasolines even come close to that standard. But G-Gas is guaranteed to exceed government specifications on every point. So, for those motorists who want a low-priced gasoline but don't want poor quality, Rio Grande now offers low-priced G-Gas.
Oh, but how about me? I've been using Rio Grande crack gasoline. Should I change to this new low-priced G-Gas?
No, sir.
Well, why not?
Well, you're getting even more value for your money. Rio Grande crack is refined to achieve United States government emergency specifications. It contains tetra-ethyl anti-knock, and the very fact that it's used in more police cars, fire engines, and emergency equipment than any other brand shows that you can't get a better gasoline for your car. Yes, sir. Rio Grande Crack is still the best gasoline value on this market. But for those folks who can't afford the slight extra cost of police car performance, Rio Grande now offers the finest gasoline made in the low price field. G-Gas.
Now it is our pleasure to present Sheriff John A. Miller of Concert Hospital County, who will speak to you from San Francisco. Sheriff Miller.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The rehabilitation of the criminal is a vast subject, a subject much too vast to be discussed in the short time allotted to me. However, there is merely one point I wish to stress here. No matter how inadequate prison facilities may be for rehabilitating the criminal, certainly he can never be made into a useful citizen by dumping him back on society before he has paid his debt. The knowledge in the underworld that paroles are a cinch breeds crime. Why should a man go straight when he knows that even if he is sentenced to prison for life, he can beat the rap within 6 or 7 years by shrewd agitation for parole? If we are to bring criminal activity to a satisfactory deadlock, we do not need a more humane attitude. We need a more stringent parole system. If there is any doubt in your mind as to the truth of what I say, listen on and hear what one parole violator did within 3 months of his release. His is not a unique case. In my opinion, it is the rule.
Mm-hmm.
nothing to say.
Clarence Stevens, this board has found you guilty of 9 charges of robbery and hereby sentences you to stand sentence penitentiary for the term prescribed by law. Board is adjourned.
Term prescribed by the law, eh? How big a letter is that, Mr. Edwards?
Well, Susan Bode will probably fix your sentence in about 5 years.
That's too long. I'll see if it'll sting me if you get to work on that parole board.
May be able to get you off of a few pages or something.
What's that amount to?
About 2.5 years.
Well, get to it. If you have any kind of a mouthpiece at all, you ought to be able to get me out.
Oh? Well, of course. It'll be a pretty heavy thing.
Don't you worry about that, man. You spring me out of the big house, and I'll have gold lined pockets in 24 hours.
So Clyde Stevens, robber, goes across the bay to San Quentin, and his attorney immediately begins to fight for his parole. Sentiment is appealed to him, and political pressure is brought to bear. 3 years pass. And finally, Edwards informs his client he will be freed at the next meeting of the parole board. A short while later, in the prison yard at San Quentin, Stevens confides to a friend.
Well, lady, I'm all set.
What do you mean, you're all set?
I'm cracking out of this joint as soon as the board meets.
Sure?
Sure. I just went to my mouthpiece.
Boy, you sure are lucky. I've tried to get out of this joint a half dozen times, but they always get me, and then it's a few months in solitary.
Yeah, I know. You don't go about it in the right way. Saws and bent wrenches. Yeah, what you need is a gat.
A gat? And where the devil can I get a gat?
Hey, listen, Woody. How'd you like to team up with me?
Why, well, but how?
I'll get the rod into you.
You will?
Sure. Now, you get a couple of guys you can depend on, and as soon as I get on the outside, I'll figure some way to slip the guns into you. We join up as soon as you make the break, and by that time, I'll have some joint case. Why, pal, we'll make that Dillinger mob look like sissies.
That'll be okay with me.
All right. Now, stop monkeying with fires and wrenches and stay out of solitary, and you'll be at the business end of a 45 within 90 days.
The board feels in granting you this parole that you have learned your lesson, that you realize the error of your ways, and that you'll not repeat your offenses again.
Oh, no, sir. I won't.
I'm sure of it.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, you will be released this afternoon in time to catch the 5 o'clock ferry. You will be expected to report to the parole office in San Francisco at 9 o'clock in the morning and inform them at that time where you'll be living and so on and so on. Now, you understand, of course, that you'll be required to make regular reports to the parole board, and you must by no means overlook this highly important obligation. We're doing you a great service, and we do not want to feel that our work in your behalf is finished.
So, on October 15, 1934, 3 months before the completion of his minimum legal term, Clyde Stevens walks out of prison a free man. Sentenced to serve from 5 years to life, he had actually spent but 3 years and 5 months in San Quentin.
On his first night of freedom, Stevens heads straight for his old hangout, a noisy restaurant on Columbus Avenue.
How does it feel to be on the outside?
Well, just well. These drinks, these games, the music. You forget how swell things look like they are after you've been caged up in a big house.
Yeah, I know. I never forget how lonely I was in Leavenworth that time I did a rap for counterfeiting.
Now, let's not think about that. We've got to make plans.
I got them all made.
Huh?
Sure. Come with me to Benny's Shack over on Sherman Island in the Sacramento River as soon as you're checked in with the parole office.
Checked in with the parole office? Listen, Al, I've had my belly full of that law. That parole office is the last place I'm going to go.
Yeah, but they might come after you.
Oh, no, they won't. You and me are going to pull a couple of jobs, and I can pay off that mouthpiece of mine. Then we'll lay low at Benny's joint over on the Delta until we can swing a couple of pals of mine from quitting. And after they
it out, we're going to blast this Pacific coast wide open, knock over a couple of million bucks for ourselves, and then take it on the land for some island in the South Sea that the world's never heard of.
9 a.m., October 16th, 1934, in the parole office, San Francisco.
Stevens, a bank robber.
How's his record?
Oh, plenty bad. They set him up for 5 years and he didn't even serve his minimum sentence.
Who? How is he?
Oh, I suppose so.
Sure, some of these specs in the prison board had our jobs a little while. Maybe they wouldn't be so eager to let these thugs loose.
Sure, what can you do? Both Quentin and Folsom are packed to the rafters. They got twice as many men in Quentin as it was built for.
Yes. Well, suppose it ever occurred to the boys to use another prison.
Well, it costs money.
Sure, and it costs money. It costs money to support an army of police and patrol officers to catch these men when they get out. Oh, that's silly, Henry. The whole system's corrupt. The joke is, well, we have what amounts to a subsidized criminal population. But it's a threat and a gang of outlaws on the taxpayers' money. And when it costs to enforce the law, and when it costs them human life and the loss of property.
All right. Don't get on the stumble, boy. What time does your bank robber do?
He's a half hour late.
Less than 24 hours out of prison, and he's broken his parole already.
Let's make a leopard change his spot. Better call the police and tell them to go look for him.
Okay.
And across the bay in Benny's Sack on Sherman Island in the Sacramento River Delta, Stephen is being entertained by Benny's wife.
You shouldn't say things like that to me, honey. My husband wouldn't like it.
Well, you don't hear what I am, so what, eh? Yeah, I like you to say things like that, don't you?
Uh-huh.
Kiss me, my kid.
Why, sure.
So how come you ever lined up with that Benny guy?
Well, he's all right, baby. Not like you, I'll admit, but he's got a good heart.
Oh, a dame like you needs more than a good heart. Hey, why don't you give him the air?
What for?
For me.
Do you mean it?
Sure, I mean it. Listen, babe, I'm going places, see? I'm going to knock over a pile of dough in the next couple of months. I show you more nice things than that cheap, pickpocket husband of yours ever could if he reached the kick of the Prince of Wales.
And I could shoot the work for that dame like you, Miller.
A Rolls Royce, dirty parlor, everyday extra apartment. Really, high class stuff. How about it, kid?
Sounds good to me.
How's about another big kiss, huh? Mm-hmm. Oh, boy. What a girl. When you're ready.
Whenever you say.
Well, just as soon as I knock over a half a dozen banks, maybe I'll set the goal.
Three weeks later, November 10th, in a branch bank on Fillmore Street, San Francisco.
Good morning, Mrs. Stanley.
Hello there, Mr. Lindley. How's the banking business?
Just fine. How's the beautiful business?
Why don't you come over sometime and you're here for bed?
Well, now I... You don't mind. I've got a little bit better to discuss with you. And I ain't got time to listen to your making jokes.
Oh, you amazing.
You're making jokes. Well, I just can't wait. Let's get him out. Listen. I need it to happen. We got this place tied up tighter than this ain't cautious. Now, I went to your cell and stub all the dough you got through that window. Come on, Toto.
Well, but I...
If I hear an alarm sound, I pull this trigger. I got everything to gain and nothing to lose.
Oh, I know, Elf. I have nothing to lose.
There you are. There. All right, Al. Stop this stuff into the bag.
Okay. All right, I got it all.
Okay, well, let's scram.
Outside of Grant's bank on Fremont Avenue in Oakland.
We saw by the door this time, Al. We've been out of luck on that last job. If those mugs would have been smart, they could have drilled us both.
Okay.
Just keep the joint covered with those two guts of yours.
Right. Let's go.
Now, you behind that tape there. This tape just back and empty everything in and just turn
you down into the
sun. All right. Now, come on now, hurry up. Y'all bought those hats. Y'all
all right.
Here you are. Okay, now, let's go.
December 17, 1934, 3 weeks later, in a small branch bank in downtown San Francisco.
Back into the door, are you?
We're out
if you want to live. Get in there. We'll call the bulls and report the robbery after we got all we want.
Well, it looks as though we can take our time on this one.
In the garage of a fashionable hotel on Nob Hill, time 3 a.m.
Good morning, gentlemen. We're looking for someone.
No, we're looking for a car.
Yeah, I think that Packard in the corner will do.
Oh, but that car blows.
Open the door, will you? I'll get back into the office there. And wait a minute. I'll open the door. Well, start off here and take care of it, please.
All right.
Go in the corner, you, and sit down. How much goes in the cash register?
Not very much.
Now, shut up. I'll look for myself. Only $10, though. Well, the car may go for that. No, I just set this spring lock to be sure to stay right here. And, oh, yeah. I don't think you'll be wanting to call up any friends at this late hour. So I just yanked this wire and his coat out of here. Well, so long, pal, and many thanks. Okay, now let's hide off.
Next morning, the two bandits, using the stolen package, take a bank on Polk Street for $7,000. And a week later, in a bank on Market Street...
Everybody stand where you are. This is a stick-up.
Look here, you
a copper, eh? A copper, huh? Go reach for that gun copper if you want to live to tell the chief about it. He means business and we blast down anybody that turns in our way. Copper all citizen and taxpayer. Now, pick up your hand. Copper, I said. That's better. Now, I just relieve you of that gun. You might hurt yourself.
Okay, Clyde, I got the stuff.
Yes. I nearly had to bump off this willy boy and blow here. He had an idea he wanted to make a hero out of himself. Let's go.
Now, tell you this situation is unbearable. We'd be the laughing stock of San Francisco. You've got to bring those men in.
What would you suggest, Chief? We've done everything we can think of, and still we can't pick them up. Why, they're the most baffling duet of bandits in San Francisco's crime annals.
Now, stop talking like a detective story magazine. Here's what I suggest. How many banks are there in downtown San Francisco?
About 50.
All right. Station two men in every bank in town. Tell them to shoot to kill. I want those two bank robbers.
Yes, sir. I'll get the dragman out at once.
We'll solve this problem.
After 120 officers staked out in various San Francisco banks, Stevens and Cecil returned to the scene of one of their crimes to hold up the bank on Polk Street once more. It is in the lull before the noon rush when Stevens approaches the teller's window while Cecil waits in the car outside.
Talk over, mister.
What?
You heard me. Empty the cash drawer.
Well, have you heard? There are two policemen stationed here.
Then hurry it up. I haven't got much time. And don't try to signal them or I'll blast you.
You'll get away with it.
Oh, no. Come on. Give.
There you are, but you'll never get through that door alive.
That's what you think. Thanks a lot for the trip, pal. So long.
Oh! Oh, they're all fire!
And no. Come on, Al. The boys are in there.
Okay.
There's another one up on the second floor window.
Well, what are you waiting for? Let him have it. Get him?
I don't know.
Two officers give chase and commandeered automobiles. The bandits easily elude them in the busy traffic of downtown San Francisco. And in the chief's office, the Council of War is held at the sheriff of San Francisco County.
Help, I want your help.
It's yours, Chief. What's on your mind?
These bank robbers,
They got away from two of my men today. That makes seven banks they've held up in 6 weeks. It's got to stop.
Certainly it should stop.
I want to organize a posse. The biggest posse in the MO? Well, anyway, a big posse. All the men in the San Francisco Police Department and all the men in the sheriff's office. We'll comb every inch of the city and county. We'll get the cooperation of the...
Yes, what is it?
We just received a tip that our
bear
brothers are hiding out on
Sherman
Island near
Antioch. Well, good. That simplifies things. Sheriff. Yes. You send a detachment of men out there tonight and mop this gang up?
Yes.
Oh, just a minute. Hello? Yes? Huh? Yes, you bet you will. Yes, sir, right away. Forget about the bank robbery, Sheriff. We've got a bigger job.
What's that?
Four convicts just kidnapped four members of the prison board from San Quentin. What? They had blue automatics. Now the question is, where did they get those guns?
Yes.
Where did they get the guns? You ask the dumbest question, girls. Where do you suppose they got them?
You?
Sure. I spanked them out of the dashboard of a prison truck 3 weeks ago. The boys are out now, and they ought to be here by tonight. Then we'll have a mob. Then we'll show these babies what a bunch of really tough rodmen can do to that thin bank.
While the nation hangs breathless to reach the cheating headlines, while millions thrilled at the Columbia Network's dramatization of a daring prison break immediately after the surge, Stevens and Cecil are in the sack on Sherman Island awaiting their reinforcements. But the Marin County Posse brings their prey to earth late in the afternoon. And the four convicts received from the creamery near Petaluma fly the white flag. So the white veterans come out with their hands in the air. Back in prison once more, the three living survivors of the kidnapped quartet are questioned by District Attorney Albert E. Bagshaw, Marin County.
Boys, I'm not going to mention any words with you. Two California laws threaten all of you with death. One says that kidnapping is a capital crime. The other says that any life farmer involved in a prison disturbance in which bodily injury occurs is liable to be executed. The latter applies to at least two of you who beat up the warden. Now, we know this is an outside job. You haven't a chance to beat the rap. I want to know where those guns came from.
Clyde Stevens sent them to us.
Shut up, you rat.
Yes, Clyde Stevens. The same guy that caught the San Francisco Dicks on the run. He's been heisting banks. We were to meet him over on Sherman Island when we got out.
You think you're yellow stool pigeon? I'll break him too.
Quiet, Kissy. That won't do you any good. You're only proving that Mackay is telling the truth. I respected you still, Mackay. You haven't changed any since you squealed in that girl and sent her to prison along with you, have you? So Clyde Stevens, the San Francisco bank robber, is also a gun runner, huh? You know him, Captain DeLay?
No, I heard. I was on my way to knock him over when this thing broke.
No, I've got him 2 ways against the middle. That boy will be in the town by midnight.
I wouldn't be too sure of that, but that guy's a killer.
It is close to midnight. The delta of the Sacramento River is shrouded in deep fog. Creeping across the slough toward Sherman Island is a posse of San Francisco police and Contra Costa County deputy sheriffs, headed by Captain DeLay and Sheriff Miller of Contra Costa County in a large scow. Close by in a speedboat are Inspectors Lynn, Ward, and Johnson.
That must be the house. Sounds like you can see something through the fog.
Yeah, seems to be the only right on the island.
Yes, sir. Then Harrington and Johnson go downstream. We'll close in from upstream.
Yes, sir.
Hiding the reeds close to the shore. In 3 minutes, I'll flash my light for a signal.
No, well, that's no good. That's
bad, too thick.
I'll whistle low, 3 times.
Then we'll close in.
Yes.
Good luck.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Careful of the shore upstream from the house.
Yes, sir.
Might run into anything in this fog.
There's no danger of a collision, is there, Eddie?
Yeah, they say so. Is there anywhere near the main channel?
Well, you never can tell, eh?
Yeah.
Must have been a
ground.
What's the matter with the captain's boat?
Yeah, still making a lot of noise over there.
Yeah, 3 minutes are up. We haven't given the signal.
Somebody coming from the house.
Yeah, they're heading this way.
You better get us off, right? Get the guns out.
Yes. I can leave these here.
When you see a senior face on that board, he's all the way from the back.
All right, boys, pick him up.
Hey, what are you doing? Away from your head.
Yes, police officer.
All right. Come on, boys.
I don't know.
Okay. Look at him. Look at my hand. Stop the pieces.
Yeah, it shows your right for pulling the gun on an officer. Where's Stephen?
He went east 3 days ago.
Before you and him held up that bank on Polk Street, I guess.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, then.
Yes, Inspector.
Then get these 3 men and stay with them. Come on, Harrington. We're going into that shack.
Okay.
Guess I didn't hear the shooting.
Will you take a look in that window?
Yeah.
Oh, come on now, Mary. How about it? Your husband won't be back for an hour.
Oh, don't look at me like that, honey. You do things to me
with your eyes. Well, there ain't nothing to what I do when I get
back. Hey, who the devil are you? Police officers. Come on, up with your hands.
Who are you looking for?
You.
What's your name, buddy?
Jack Willis.
Where are you from?
Oakland.
Oh, yeah? That's right, Stephen. Last address, Ben Clinton. Next address, Wilson.
Oh, no, officer. On the level, his name's Willis. It isn't quite Stephen.
Yeah? Here, take a look at this mug and police record.
Clyde Stephen. Wanted for bank robbery.
Yeah, looks like your pal, is on it.
Yes, the death. Willis.
Your parents taken away.
Oh, Clyde, honey. They're going to take me away. Kiss me, honey. Oh, kiss your baby. Gee, I'm going to miss you.
Save it, lady, save it. Come on, Stephen. Your apartment's waiting in the city jail.
By the time Johnson, Carrington, and Lynn have taken their prisoners down to the shore, Captain DeLay's boat is free, and the officers return across the black, fog, shrouded water to each day with their captives. They leave the boat in Antioch, and as they are walking through the deserted streets of the little town to their waiting police car.
I never confess, Stephen. Bank robbery and gun running are too nasty yet.
I don't know anything about him. What are you going to do, sir? You're going to stop me.
Look out, boys. Stephen's making a break for us.
Oh, stop real fast.
All right.
You're in the arms of that patrolman. That was the corner.
Come on.
Okay.
I'm going to pick that guy. That's a big idea, Stephen.
You just ain't never going to take me alive. Go on, pump me off.
I don't think it'll be necessary, but if you don't come quietly, why... I guess we'll have to take you unconscious. Come on, boys.
For 3 days, San Francisco police questioned Clyde Stevens, and finally he confessed to the bank robberies and to his part in the San Quentin prison break. On January 23, 1935, less than 4 months after his parole from San Quentin, Clyde Stevens was sentenced to Folsom Penitentiary along with his partner, Albert Kessel. There to spend the rest of his natural life, unless another sympathetic parole board frees him in 1970, when he will again be eligible for parole. Police have to meet emergencies many times every day, but so do you. Every time you drive your car, you meet driving emergencies when you need extra power and speed to snatch you out of the way of traffic dangers. It costs you no more to use the same gasoline that police cars and emergency engines use. Rio Grande cracks gasoline. It has been selected to power more police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment than any other brand. This is proof that Rio Grande cracks is not only the speediest and most powerful gasoline, but also the most economical. You get more for your money in Rio Grande cracks gasoline.
Cisco police calling all cars, attention all cars. Cancellation broadcast 107 regarding Clyde Stevens, a parole violator. This man is now in custody. That's all.
offered by the Rio Grande Oil Company. Ask your Rio Grande dealer for the latest free copy of the Calling All Cars News, and read how to get your free gift. This is a narrative of Frederick Lindsley.